relief rally here in equities,
mm-hmm.
because the markets may have discounted already a lot of bad news. And the news will stay bad, but maybe the news will not get much worse than we've already seen. So the market may rebound. And if there is a rebound in equity prices, maybe there's some money that will come out of the gold market and flow into equity markets temporarily.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I'm not giving up on gold. I think we are in the early stages of a longer term upward move in gold, simply because wherever you look in the world, central banks will print money.
Mm-hmm.
And the worse the economy becomes, the more money they will print.
Mm-hmm.
And fiscal deficits will go up. And so the purchasing power of paper money will diminish over time, and gold will therefore be a reasonable investment.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, it may still go down. We had a peak in March 2007 at over 1,000, and then we went down below 700.
Mm-hmm.
And then we rallied again to 1,000, and now we're above 900.
Right.
We could easily go back to 700, 800.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we can also go up to, I don't know, 300,000, 100,000. That's why when people say, I claim that the S&P will go to 500, I'm not sure, because mm-hmm. if you print enough money,
mm-hmm.
the S&P will not go to right. 500, but it will go up.
I should point out that I'm paraphrasing a lot of, because we're getting a lot of questions on gold, more or less the same. What is the future? Are inflation expectations built in? Some people are asking, let me just bring up one as an example.
Yes.
The people who felt that gold, the nominal price has gotten a little bit out of reach. Nawang writes in, do we have this one from Nawang, just to show that not everything is focused on gold, but also other precious metal classes, the poor man's or poor person's gold. I've invested in silver. When is the next bull run going to occur in this space? By the way, I have a 100-ounce bar of silver I bought
yes.
in high school.
I'm very good.
Holding on to it. Really good?
Yes, that's
good. Am I going to be able to retire on it?
But I mean, you know, people always ask me about silver and so forth. I prefer gold because it's easier to store physical gold mm. than to store physical silver.
Right.
And it's easier to carry a kilo of gold than a kilo of silver. And a kilo of gold has much more value than a kilo of silver.
Mm-hmm.
But in a bull market, I suppose that silver will also go up. I would say actually that platinum is relatively inexpensive.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I don't want to debate about people about which will perform the best, silver, gold, platinum, or palladium. They all move in concert. There are times when silver will outperform gold, and there are times when gold outperforms silver.
Mm-hmm. But you like base metals now, for some reason. It's not as sexy, and you certainly can't store it in your home safe.
No, but you understand, industrial commodities have totally collapsed. And at this level, the CRB, inflation adjusted, is at the lowest level in 200 years.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there's a case to be made to invest in, say, commodities other than gold.
Mm-hmm.
Gold, compared to the rest of the commodities, relatively expensive.
Okay. Real estate. Should we be buying real estate? This is an oft-repeated question today. In fact, Gregory and others, Michael, right?
Real estate where? And what kind of real estate?
Well, just saying that, you know, in properties, would it make sense?
Yes.
Because it's got a utilitarian value.
Well, I would essentially stay away from properties in financial centers mm-hmm. and in big cities. But I would buy, say, a farm, or in secondary cities.
Chiang Mai, Thailand.
As an example, or Vietnam, or China.
Uh-huh.
In China, property prices have come down. They will come down further.
Okay.
But they're not terribly expensive.
When we come back and ask a little more about farmland, Michael writes in, what about farmland? Well, yeah, at least you can grow stuff on it. Charles Monat is founder and chairman of Charles Monat Associates, biggest independent life insurance provider here in Hong Kong. And, of course, Mark Faber is with us. Dr. Doom has done so well over the years, he doesn't need insurance. Self-insurance. Charles, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much, Bernie.
Do you find that when, you know, I have to admit, the first thing I did was I knew I had an AIA policy. The first thing I did was, oh, my God, you know, I wonder what this means for me. I mean, do you get a lot of questions like that?
People do ask those questions, and we assure them that the policy is ring-fenced. The assets backing up the policy are conservative. There's a lot of capital and surplus with the company. So, in fact, that's the main point is credibility. People are saying, can I trust the insurance company?
Mm-hmm.
But we deal only with major companies that are Standard & Poor's AA or better.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a wonderful record of both paying claims and paying a lot of cash out. Last 3 months or so, we paid about $25 million
yeah.
in loans, withdrawals. people were so happy to have this money, mm-hmm. and they can't believe it's getting 4 or 5% interest. They say, mm-hmm. how could this
wow.
money get such a high interest? Please explain it. So we explain it. Yeah. The assets of the insurance companies are really in bonds, and they're getting 6 or 6.3 or 6.5. So they'll go back and credit the inside cash value, mm-hmm. 5 or 5.5 or even 6%.
Right.
For Americans, it's tax deferred. For non-Americans, there's no tax.
And it makes you look like heroes nowadays in this age of capital preservation. 4 or 5% yeah. makes it looks like an absolute mint. Mark,
yes.
what do you think of insurance?
Well, it depends. If you have a family and you have a salary and you have no money for emergencies, then I would say, yeah, insurance. But I would always be concerned that the insurance can pay mm-hmm. because, strictly speaking, AIG is bankrupt. Mm-hmm. Now, the government is bailing them out, and the policy holders will get paid, that I'm sure. My wife, by the way, has also a policy at AIG. Although I told her not to do it, but as you know, wives don't listen to good husbands.
Uh-huh. Have you seen business go down? A lot of people said to my, I am not going to outsource my golden years and my age of need to an insurance company if I don't know what they're doing beneath the surface. So therefore, I'm going to do this myself. I'm going to invest in ETFs, and I'm going to buy term insurance only. I'm not going to let my insurance company make investment decisions on my behalf.
Well, Bernie, actually, it's gone the other way, especially mm-hmm. the last couple of months. September, October, people were kind of nervous. But then we found business started picking up again because the credibility of these insurance companies was very good. Mm-hmm. They were able to pay their loans, withdrawals, and claims. We paid about $100 million in death claims over the years out here.
Wow.
Got about 8,000 clients all over the region, including the U.S. and Europe. Mm-hmm. And when they see the turnaround time and the ability of these companies to pay, mm-hmm. they're actually coming in with more money now than they did a year or two ago.
But what are you investing in, though? I mean, the insurance, it's not like you have secret investments that none of us knows about, right?
These are the insurance companies investing basically in a very healthy bond portfolio. Double A or better, or single A bonds. Mm-hmm. They have a lot of cash in surplus, mm-hmm. a lot of excess money, mm-hmm. and they're well above the solvency margins required by the governments they deal with around the world, which mm-hmm. include Canada, the U.S., Bermuda, Hong Kong, and Singapore, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So people realize that the companies have tremendous credibility.
Okay. Mark, let me throw this one. This is more of a Mark question. Now, Wong writes in, which I presume somebody from where? NP, I don't know where that is. Thanks. Would appreciate if you check this out. At 30 or 40 cents, is AIG stock ready for the picking? I'm getting a lot of these questions, like Citi at one, Citi at a buck and a half.
Yeah, I mean,
worth a punt, worth a double?
You know, if a stock drops from $100 to $1, it can rebound easily to $5 or $10,
yeah.
the same for AIG.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I'm not in this game. I think that if you had a total collapse in the market, say NASDAQ after 2000,
mm-hmm.
it then had a strong rebound and a lot of tech stocks doubled, and today the NASDAQ is basically back to its low in 2002.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at least with the NASDAQ today, I can say, we've built essentially a major base, 2002 to 2009, 7 years base. So I would rather buy some tech stocks here.
Mm-hmm. You'd rather buy tech stocks. We'll deal with that in the next section, since we have Charles in this section of the show here. So you're claiming